guys, welcome back to my channel. Today it is Wednesday, so we are going to talk about some new makeup releases. But before I do, I wanna very shortly address these world events we are in right now. The coronavirus is spreading everywhere and making this a very unique experience for everyone. I hope you are safe. I hope you and your family are healthy and that you are able to stay home and stay safe and that you're not too much bothered by this. Of course, it's bothering everyone, but I hope that this does not mean that you have lost your job or anything like that. I am at the moment also at home with my husband. I'm fortunate enough to have a job where I can work from home, so hence the hoodie. In Holland, we have not a complete lockdown, but schools are closed. All the restaurants and cafes, bars, stuff like that are closed. A lot of big stores are closing. Supermarkets are thankfully still open, but are being raided because, you know, people are trying to get a lot of toilet paper somehow for some reason. So yeah, so that's a thing, but we're coping the best we can. I have decided just to keep uploading as I would usually, because I think YouTube can be a very nice distraction. You could be a bit bored, so you know, you could watch some more videos on YouTube. So if we all stop and let this get to us, I think that is not really the way we should go forward, but to each his own. So yeah, so I wanted to address that for a little bit. Know that I am not an expert on anything, so I'm not going to tell you what to do or anything like that, but I wanted to touch on it because it feels a little bit weird to just chat about new makeup and not address it. So let's jump into the video. As per usual, I'm going to be on the Beauty News Official, Trend Mood and Indie Makeup Spotlight page for new makeup. I have selected a few things I would like to talk about, not by any means everything that is coming out or has been announced, but just the stuff that was like, oh, okay, gave me the double take, as Samantha March would say. Speaking of her, she has a community playlist where a lot of us creators who are creating this type of video are uploading their videos to that playlist. So if you want to check that out and find some new creators, which is always fun, then check down the description box. I have linked everything down there. Yeah, so let's jump in. I'm going to scoot you. I'm going to see what I want to do, and then we go into the new makeup. Okay, well, we were talking about Samantha March, and I want to start with her new collaboration with Ofra Cosmetics. She has released a personal highlight, or a highlight she assembled. She made a highlight with Rodeo Drive and Pillow Talk, I believe, and it was sold out, I think, quite quickly. It didn't ship to Holland, so that was a thing. I hope this collection will, because she has made a full collection with Ofra Cosmetics, and I must say it looks so stunning. I have watched her live announcement. I haven't been able to watch her video telling us more about these, but she showed the products there and they look so very beautiful. So let's go through the products. She has released the highlighter duo again. It's going to be $35. It's Star Island and Pillow Talk. Then there's also a Chick Lit blush duo that is $35. Side one is a matte pink nude, and side two is a shimmer deep rose. Then the River Bronze Duo is $35. Then you have the one side is matte and is in the light neutral mocha color, and the other side is a shimmer warm copper. And then you have a lip duo where you get Story, that is a matte maca nude mauve, and you get Millie, that is a Claus Pearl iridescent shimmer gloss. It's releasing this Friday on the 20th, I believe it's the 20th. Yeah, it's the 20th, but you can already get the PR box. It's in a pre-sale. I checked yesterday and it's still there. So if you want it, go to ofracosmetics.com, because you can buy the PR box, and the PR box is going to be $129. What I love about this collection is that it is very Samantha. If you watch her, then you know these colors are very much her aesthetic. Please, I'm going to link down the video where she's announcing and telling more about the whole collection, but I love the name she chose. It's very personal. And liquid lip you see in the picture looks very dark, but it isn't. It's a very nice deep mauve, typically Samantha March color. So Samantha, congratulations. I don't know if you will be watching this, but sometimes you do Isn't that great? She's a great lady. She's like almost at 100k followers, but she still watches some of my videos on these that I make, and I have like 200 subs. That's a class act, man. That's a class act. So I want to congratulate you, Samantha. I hope this is going to sell out like crazy, but not before I got it. The only thing is, I am on a no-buy, but I'm seriously contemplating breaking my no-buy to get this because I'm so proud of her and I so deeply, deeply want to support her. So yeah, I'm trying to decide. It's going on the wish list for sure. But yeah, I might break my no-buy, but I have to think about it because I'm doing really good. Okay, next we go to Viseart. Viseart has released another small 8-pen palette. It's called Choo Choo and it's in the Petit Pro line. They say about this palette that it is inspired by summertime travels of carefree beach days filled with snow cones and sweets. It's a limited edition and so if you want it, you have to go out and get it. It doesn't say until when, but it never does. It's already launched. It's $30 as usual, I think, for these small ones. And so if you want it, you should really pick it up. I think it's a very fun, cute color story. I think I'm going to try and pick it up, but I'm not going to pick it up before my no-buy is gone. I'm not going to break my no-buy for this. It is going on the wish list because I really, really enjoy these small Petit Pro, and you have the other ones, the edits, I think. I think they're called the edits. These are the 12 pen palettes, but they're very, very small. So it's so easy to travel with them. I love the color stories and the prices stay nice and affordable-ish. Because if you buy the big one, you're going to be paying like $150 or $180. And this is like $30. So this is okay, it's okay enough, and this is not something you are going to go and hit pan on very soon. So I think this is a very cute palette, and it's the second thing that's going on the wish list. I've only been talking about two things. Oh dear. Okay, then there are two things by ColourPop. ColourPop is launching a Mulan collection. It's launching on the 19th of March, so that is tomorrow. And I think this is because there's this live action movie coming out from Mulan and they are celebrating with this collection. It's going to contain a shadow eyeshadow palette for $22, a luxe creme lipstick in Huha Mulan for $9, a luxe velvet liquid lipstick in Strong Chi that is going to be $9, a luxe gloss in Phoenix, $9, a lip bundle for $25, and I think you can get everything for $25. They will save you some money, I believe. Yep, $2. A pressed powder blush, $10 in two shades, Good Luck Charm and Matchmaker. Then there's also a Fourth Ray Beauty Face Milk and Lip Mask Bundle for $16. And the full collection you can get for $78. I think it looks cute. It's very dark, very Chinese, very... Is it Chinese Mulan? I don't even know for sure. But yeah, it looks really, really Mulan. And I think that ColourPop can pump this stuff out very easily and very quickly. So yeah, it looks good. I think that the PR package you see in the picture, I think it's the PR package, looks very much like a Chinese cabinet. So I think it's very much on theme. The aesthetics, like the designs on the palette, on the lipsticks and stuff, it looks very... I think if ColourPop does something like this, they do it well, and I think that is very nice. It is not for me, so I am going to skip over this, but I can imagine you wanting to pick something up from this. It's all very neutral but very on theme, I would imagine, because if you're a warrior, you're not going to wear like clownish makeup. So yeah, it's very on theme, I would say. Then the second thing from ColourPop is their mauve collection. It's launching tomorrow, it says, but that was the 12th, so it's already here. You can get a Making Mauves palette. There are no prices in this post, so I think, I don't know for sure, but I think that the palette is going to be $12 because it's normally the usual price for their 9-pen palettes. You also can get some blushes, the Catch Me Vibe and Coast to Coast, so that's two shades. There's also the Luxe Gloss in the shades Check-In and Figgy with it. And then the Super Shock Shadows for Super Shock Shadows in two shades, Day Tripping and Bloomer. Yeah, it's mauve. It looks very approachable. It looks very, everybody can wear this. This is not a very difficult palette to put on your eyes. I think it's very nice to have, like, if you have the coconuts palette, then this would be nice, a nice complimentary one, I think, because it's very neutral, it's very everyday, but it's not going to the very neutral colors. You can have a little bit of a mauve vibe. So if you are into like neutral colors and neutral looks, I think this is a very nice collection. I don't know if it's really screaming to me, because I had this other one, I think it was the Blush Crush or something. It's very similar. I think it's a little bit lighter, a little bit more pinkish even than this is, because this leans on the neutral side more than the Blush Crush, I think, what I can remember of it, to be honest. And yeah, so this is not something that is going on my wishes, but I can imagine it's very, very easy makeup, so why not, you know? It's nice, it looks cute. Then we're going over to Clinique. They are launching a Moisture Surge Pop Triple Lip Balm. I did that in one go. In six shades. What it says is that this product is a 3-in-1. From the outer layer inwards, you'll find a lip gloss, a lip balm, and lip color. The Moisture Surge... And now I won't be able to do it again. The Moisture Surge Pop Triple Lip Balm claims the moisturizer contains aloe, shea butter, and vitamin E, and is light and non-sticky with a soft shine finish. And the shades are going to be goji berry, dragon fruit, acai, lychee, black honey, and grapefruit. It's launching in Japan in April, and then the other region are to be communicated. For summer, this looks so nice. So nice. I used to have a Clinique lip balm. I wasn't really blown away by it, but can you imagine having these very like wash of color on your lips, but if they actually would like taste and scent like the names, that would be great. Because I had this one, this, I think it was a very pinkish one, a coral one. Didn't really like it that much, but because I had eczema at the time and I wanted a wash of color and I needed something to hydrate my lips, I bought that one. It had a very, very weird smell and taste to it. Really clinically, really, no pun intended, clinically, really. So I want to smell them before I'm going to buy them. I have no clue if this will come to Holland, but I think this is a very smart, very summer, spring, summer type of release, because it's easy, you know? It's like you don't want to have the heavy makeup, you just want a wash of color, you want something to hydrate your lips, make them look plump and fresh. Yeah, I think it's a smart release. I'm not going to put it on the wishlist by any means. If I'm going to come across it, then great, but I'm not going to seek it out. Then Jouer. Jouer have launched two new blush bouquet duos. I think this has released quite a while ago, because I have been seeing this around, because I was intrigued by it. And I forgot to talk about it in the last two, episodes I did of these. So I wanted to just touch on them right now. What it says, a blush duo that offers a velvety smooth and full pigment color blend for a perfect finish. And you always get more of a satin and more of a matte type of formula in these. So you can start with the matte one and then buff it out a little bit, the shimmery one. That's the way I like to use it, because I don't like to have a lot of shimmer like on the apples of my cheek, but I like to keep it here. As you can see, I have my highlight more here, because Robert Welch taught me that if you put on highlighter, you have to put on highlighter where the light naturally would hit your face. So I'm trying to do that. I don't know if I'm succeeding, but I'm trying to do that. So yeah, so what I really love about these is that you can of course use just the shimmer or just the satin or just the matte, but I think it's very nice complimentary deal you get with these little duos. As you can see, they are, I don't know about the light one, because I think the light one is very stark on the arm with the deeper skin tone. But I think that the other one, the right one, is very nice on deeper skin tone. But also, it intrigues me a little bit, because I really would love to try it on my skin tone. I'm not necessarily very fair, but I am light to medium. Sometimes I'm medium, I swear sometimes I am. But mostly light, I'm not necessarily fair, but I'm like light medium. Let's say like light medium. But I would be very curious to see how this would react on my skin, especially in summer, because if you have a bit more of a tan, then it would be very fun to see what that would do. Maybe it can be a contour shade, or I don't know. It looks very intriguing to me. The left one, so the most pinky one, is Darling, and you get the shade Embrace Me, that's the warm satin, and Love Me, it's the warm satin peachy pink. So you have the toast and the peachy pink. I'm sorry, I'm not saying that correctly. And then you have, oh, you've got two satins in one. Okay. And then you have the other one, the darker one, that's Passion. You get the shade Cherish Me, that's a warm matte burnt amber, and Treasure Me, a warm shimmery bronze tangerine. You know what I would have loved? If they would have also put some pictures in without the swatches, because I think these swatches are very heavy, so they can show the color of these products. But I would have loved to see them also on the face, you know, to see what would have what it would have looked like. So yeah, but these are very nice. I really like Jouer. I have two products, lip gloss and this blush duo, and I really enjoy it. I'm really going to try more from them this year. I just have to see what I want to try. I think their concealer was very intriguing. This is not necessarily going on the wish list, but I think it's a very nice release. Okay, then we're going to Fenty, because Fenty have revealed a new shade of their Diamond Balm and Body Lava. It's called Cognac Candy, and I think they are going to release two types of products, if I'm not mistaken, because they are going to release the Diamond Balm in Cognac Candy, that's going to be $39, and the Body Lava in Cognac Candy is going to be $59. It's going to launch this Friday on their website and in Sephora, I think, or on Sephora. I hope it's also coming to Sephora stores. But yeah, so I think this looks quite intriguing, because if you see the swatches on the top product, the Diamond Balm, I'm not going to go and buy the Body Lava. I'm not someone who will use that, but I think that the top swatches look very, very nice also for more lighter skin tone, because she has this, what's it called, Trophy Wife, I think. And that is so gold that I would never wear that on my face. But these look like you could wear them throughout more or several skin tones. I'm not really sure if it would look too icy on the deeper skin tone. But you know, it's Fenty. I think they would have done some research on how this is looking and if it looks okay, or if you can get away with it if you have a deeper skin tone. So yeah, this looks intriguing. I'm not going to get it, but yeah, I thought it would be fun to talk about it. Then I'm going over to Charlotte Tilbury. She is launching a new Eye Color Magic collection. It contains of 4 eye quads and 4 double-ended eye pencils. I saw Michelle Wong already review these. She bought them all, swatched them, and I think she used the blue one. The blue one is super blue. And I think she kind of liked it. The only thing that was a bit weird is that the Rebel, the new Rebel, because she has the Rebel in more of a teal type of tone, and now she has the new Rebel, so that's the green one. But in this collection, it's called Green Light, so that's a bit weird. But you have these 4, you have the luxury palettes are going to be $40. No, pounds. I'm sorry, that's a little bit more dollars. £40. You have the shade Copper Charge, Green Lights, also known as the Rebel, it says, Super Blue and Mesmerizing Maroon, and you also have these Eye Color Magic Liner Duos. They have the same name, and they're going to be £21. It's already available. It looks really nice. I really want to dabble into some more Charlotte Tilbury this year, so I think I'm going to get the Rebel, or the Green Lights, if it's still there. The only thing I heard is that the Green Lights is the only one that is going to be limited edition. I'm not sure, but I heard it through the grapevine. So please keep that in mind if you're trying to get these. Not I'm saying you have to run out and get them right away, but you know, see if you can find some information about it. Yeah, it is going on the wish list because I also think that these duo-ended magic liners look really nice. I think one side is matte and the other side is shimmery. So I think you can do some very fun, very cool things with these liners as well. And what I love about, you know, Charlotte Tilbury makeup is mainly that it's trying to enhance you. So it's always quite safe on the color sides. And I think it's really fun that she is bringing out some more color. So she's speaking to a little bit of a bigger audience. And she has reformulated, I believe, her eyeshadows. I haven't tried the old formula. I haven't tried the new ones. A new one, but I, you know, I watch a lot of Michelle Wong. I watch a lot of Mel Thompson, and they usually try these products out. And they were saying that she changed her formula and she changed it for the better. So, yeah, it's quite expensive because I think in euros. I'm sorry, I'm just my hair is bothering me. I'm sorry. In euros, these are, I think, 50 to 53 euros. So I think I would imagine they're like $50 as well. They are quite expensive. It's only 4 shades, so it's quite an expensive quad. But yeah, I still want to try them. And I think it's fun. Oh, I think it's good that she changed her formula. And it, at least it's for the better because, you know, it's a lot of money. So you want something good. Then Sigma. I have touched on this last week because they are releasing a new... what's it called? The Rosa eyeshadow palette, and they are also releasing some Infinite Point lipsticks. I showed you one. I took a screenshot from the little clip that was playing, but we have some more shades now. They are going to release 4 shades. They are already available on their website. They are $25 each, and you get the shades Ecstasy. That's a Sapphire. Scarlet Red, then you have Deja Vu, that's a soft cognac nude. Temptation, that's a dark mulberry mauve. And Epiphany, that's a bright peach nude. Very nice colors though. I think they look really nice. All 4 of them look really pretty. They are saying about these lipsticks that you can achieve your most flawless lip yet with these innovative lipsticks in 4 elegant shades. Featuring a unique patented ridge, these lipsticks are designed to stay in a perfect point throughout use, allowing for precise and beautiful application every time. That's cool. That would be something nice for the Beauty News girls to test, you know, if that is really going to be the case, if they would keep that shape. Yeah, they look really nice. I've never tried anything Sigma when it comes to their lip products. I only have their brushes, but I've never used anything from their makeup. I have put the, I think it's Corda Rosa. I don't remember. I'm sorry. The Rosa palette I talked. Sorry, there was someone at the door, so I don't know where I left this off, but I'm not going to put them on the wish list. But they look really nice. Okay, then I'm going over to Too Faced because they have added to their Peach Perfect line, they have added a concealer. It's a potted concealer. They are already available in 18 shades for $22. They say it's an instant coverage matte formula, oil-free, long-wearing concealer. A concealer that instantly hides redness, dark spots, blemishes, and acne. Well, that's what a concealer should do. It's enriched with porcelain flower extract. I don't know what it is and if it does anything, but okay, sure. And then vitamin E and hyaluronic acid. Sounds nice. I want to try some more potted, or not potted, concealers in general. I'm just not going to get anything from Too Faced because, you know, we haven't forgot the Nikki thing. So we're moving on to Indie. I'm already at Indie. Wow, I'm doing good. I'm not going to say this is going to be a short one because it never really is, but you know, we are already at Indie, but I have a few things. So I'm going to start off with Melt Cosmetics because they are releasing, or they have released, their Rust collection, and it contains of a palette, I think a eyeliner, yes, a gel eyeliner, and a 2 lipsticks. I'm sorry, I'm just, you know. Okay, I'm going to just read about it. It says, the collection includes a Rust palette that is going to be $58, a gel liner in burnish. That's a red brown. That's really, really nice. Very rusty. It's an ultra matte gel liner. That is going to be $19. And then there is the Rust Collection that contains the Rust Palette, the Burnish Gel Eyeliner, and two Ultra Matte Lipsticks in 1969 and Mural. They are permanent shades, but they're being re-promoted in this collection. And if you want to get the full collection, it's going to cost you $70. I think that is a very nice, that's a good deal, because the palette is $58. The liner is $19, so it's already cheaper to buy those two in the bundle, but you also get two lipsticks. That's a good deal. That's a good deal. I'm so fighting with my hair lately. I think I have to go back and cut it shorter again. And then, you know, have it a little bit differently. Because I am struggling. I'm on a struggle bus. You know, the problem is with this collection, I have a feeling they are at the moment getting their stacks into palettes. I don't know why that is. Maybe because the stacks are not selling anymore, or it's just a formula people are not vibing with. I don't know. The thing is though, I have the Rust stack and I have that blue with the brown stack, and I have one palette, I think, the Gemini palette. I like all of them, but the Rust stack is one of my favorite formulas. And the Gemini palette I like, but it's not my favorite formula. I don't think it's a bad formula per se, it's just not my favorite. So the fact that they're putting the Rust stack into a palette formula, I don't know. I don't want to say it's a bad idea. I don't want to say it's like, because there are a lot of people who really enjoy their palette formula over the stack formula, so it is a different formula. It's obviously a different formula. So I am very intrigued to see what they did with the formula. One, two, I'm not going to get it because I already have the stack, and I also have that blue stack where you get four shimmer shades in brownie tones, neutral tones. So the only reason why I would have gotten this one is because I only have the Rust stack. That is a totally matte stack, and I don't have the shimmers. I'm not really that blown away by their shimmers anyway, so I don't think I would get them just for that. But that would be an incentive, you know, to say, okay, I'm going to get it because I don't have the shimmers. But other than that, I love the color story. Okay, sorry, I was saying I had to change my battery. My husband is singing, so I'm just going to let him do that. What I wanted to say about the Rust stack is I really love the formula. I really love the color tones. You can create a very nice, blended, blown out, smoky, effortless, really, it looks effortless, but it blends so nicely. Look, it's all matte, and I really like an all matte. I don't need an all matte look. I don't need to have shimmers in my looks. So I really enjoy the Rust stack, so I'm not going to get this. Then I'm going over to Sugar Pill, because Sugar Pill released another of those pill or capsule collections. It's called the C2. It's going to be, or is, $42, and it's only at Ulta. So that is something that I hate, because I am in Holland. There's not an Ulta in Holland. I can't get to this, but I really like the color story. I think it's very fun. I think it's fun to have all these mauves and nice and neutral stuff, and then have these, I know it's annoying, but these two pops of colors with the yellow, three pops of color. So I think it's a nice palette, and I think these look so cute, these the design on these palettes. But yeah, I can't get to it, so that's a thing. I hope they are going to release them on, I think Selfridges is also selling Sugar Pill, so I hope, is it Sugar Pill or is it Lime Crime? No, I think it's Lime Crime, or both. I don't know. I don't remember. I'm sorry. But I would love to get this, but yeah, it's okay that I can't. It's not like, you know, these shades are not something I would have in my collection, but I think it would be a nice palette to try the formula from Sugar Pill, because I've never have. So yeah. Okay, then I'm going to something from Lunatic Cosmetics. Or Lunatic Cosmetic Labs. It's not a very known brand to me, but I thought this looked very interesting. They have a new palette that is called the Descendant palette. It's already available, and it's going to cost you $42. And what I think is very cool is that it's fully neutral, fully matte, fully neutral. It looks very stunning. It's a very grungy look, but I think that's their aesthetic anyway. So I think this looks really cool. The only thing I would have loved, because I'm going to put a picture up of the outside packaging as well, if they would have had these greens and blues and purples and teals like in there as well, because it looks really cool. It looks very nice, and I think it totally speaks to their customer base, because I think they know best what they want. But if you look at it like this, there are two shades I think that are a bit redundant, and if you replace them with like duochromes of this, like a blue that shifts purple and a teal that shifts, I don't know, also blue or maybe purple, or maybe a multichrome, just one multichrome that has this oily shift you see in the because I think it's a cutout of a stone, or a stone I think, or mineral, what you call it, I don't know. But I think that would have been so cool. But that's the only thing I think, yeah, that would have really made this palette. But I think it's very nice. I think it looks nice. I think you can get some very nice looks out of this. It looks a little bit, it doesn't look like, because that palette has a lot of shimmers, but it has the same feel as the coconut palette from Going Coconuts. What's it called? Yeah, the Going Coconuts palette from Colourpop. You know, it's a little bit more red if you look at it like this, but it's very neutral. And I think this is the same aesthetic, and I really like, I really like those aesthetics right now. A lot of people are going for the neutrals. That's very fun. So yeah, I'm not going to get this, but I thought it was interesting. I wanted to show you. Then we go over to Menagerie Cosmetics. I have two things. One is their upcoming pastel pop palette. It's going to be full of pastel colors. It looks really, really cute. The front of the palette looks so cute, very nice. I saw something floating around, I think it was on Instagram or Twitter, one of those things, where they were saying that they were accused of using someone's pictures as a very heavy inspiration. It could be the case, but you know, it's just a picture of a seal pup. They kind of look this, you know, I know it's not, I think it's very important to always credit artists and stuff like that, but sometimes it goes a little far, I think. But you know, that's just my very probably very unpopular opinion, but I think it was a bit much. But they are going to compensate the artist for the fact that their picture looks a lot like their front of the palette, so that is nice. I think that is very grown up of them, very good. So yeah, I would love to try Menagerie Cosmetics this year, and this could be something I'm going to start with, because I really want a pastel, I'm always saying that wrong, pastel palette this year, because I think it's fun to have one palette that is this rage type of thing, and to have it in my collection and to have some fun with it. So I think I'm going to put this on the wish list. I don't know if I'm going to get it, but I'm going to put it on the wish list. And then the second thing they have revealed is that they are going to come out with new trefoil shadows. They are going to launch on the 21st of March for $6 each. I'm going to see that if I'm going to place my order at the end of April, because I'm not going to bring my no-buy for these for this pastel pop palette, then I'm going to see if I can get these shadows as well. So I'm going to put them on the wishlist. I have a lot of stuff on the wishlist this week. Oops. Okay, then I'm almost done. It's the second to last thing. This is the new Far Out palette by Peachy Queen. It's very new on. It looks very, is it 90s a tie-dye thing? The front of the palette looks very fun. It's not something I'm going to get, because this is not something I wear. I think I have one rainbow palette and I've never touched it. So I'm not going to get out and get this, but I think it's so, so fun. It's already available, so if you want it, you can get it on their website, I would believe. If you check out their Instagram, or indie brands are very good and keeping you posted on their Instagram, so yeah. Or just follow Indie Makeup Spotlight, of course. I've linked her down below so you can find the post there. I wanted to show you because it looks so fun. Those bright colors, and you can match them with some nice shimmers. It looks really, really nice. It's just not for me. I'm not going to get this, but yeah, I wanted to show you. And then the last thing is by Lunar Sky Cosmetics. She's already warning for low stock because these somehow they were floating around on Twitter. And I think I just have a lot of people who love Lunar Skies on Twitter because I see them in my feed like all the time, every day a few times. But she has been announcing these palettes not for a while. She's just sneak peeking them and showing them and asking what people think of them. And I think they look really, really nice. The blue one and the teal one, I think, especially the teal one, the shades are a little bit repetitive, I think. But it's a very nice, cool color story. I think it's nice that it looks very monochromatic, but it isn't really, because you have some other colors as well, so you can combine the looks, and it's not always just blue teal, and you can combine it with a little bit of moss green and the glitter, or you can use the very bright neon yellow or orange, not orange, but orangey yellow to combine it with. I think that is really fun. I don't know, I really want to try the brand because I see a lot of people raving about them, but I'm not going to get anything from them before my no buy is done. So I'm just going to, I know they're going to be floating around anyway, I will be able to find them. I think they look really, really nice. You can get only one, but you can get the bundle for $55 as long as it's all in stock. So if you want it, you should be very, very quick. It's Lunar Skies Cosmetics. So if you go to the Indie Makeup Spotlight, oh no, I found it on her own. I think Indie Makeup Spotlight will have a post about it as well, but I found it on her Instagram. So guys, that was it for me today. Such a weird thing to be filming this, but you know, as I said before, I hope this was a bit of a distraction for you, getting you out of the boredom slump for just being at home and not going anywhere. It's so boring not being able to go to restaurants and stuff like that, but it's very necessary, I believe. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. Remember that everything goes on sale eventually, so if you can, hold on to your knickers and don't go out and rush into buying something you might get on sale if you just wait a teensy tiny bit. So I hope you liked this video. Give it a thumbs up if you did, and I hope I will see you in my next one. And don't forget to subscribe. Bye!